How do you see the pace of innovation right now in AI startups? And does it trouble you how quickly some of these companies are moving and then changing direction?
Yes, I am extremely troubled with how quickly we are releasing generative AI systems without the transparency to know where the data is coming from. And also, we continue to see data being taken without consent, without compensation. And you're going to continue to see increasing lawsuits against companies that are built on what some would say is stolen data. You had Meta, Facebook settle $650 million when it came to violating the BIPA, Biometric Information Privacy Act of Illinois. So I think it's extremely risky for companies to be building on unstable foundations.
Dr. Joy, what were the specifics of your discussion with President Biden? Yes, artificial intelligence, but what did he want to know?
So I was very encouraged by how engaged President Biden was at the roundtable, and we started off discussing the possibilities of AI for healthcare, for education, but quickly focused on real-world harms of AI. And so I focused on racial bias, gender bias, and known false matches that have led to false arrests, such as the case of Robert Williams, who was arrested in front of his two young daughters and his wife due to faulty AI system. So that was certainly top of mind. I also think there's an opportunity for the U.S. to lead on biometric rights, but right now we're going in the opposite direction. Last week, we had EU lawmakers push forward the EU AI Act, which has a provision that bans the use of live facial recognition in public places. While this is happening here in the U.S., we have the TSA rolling out domestic facial recognition, and most people don't even know that they can opt out. So that's why we're doing the TSA scorecard, fly.ajl.org, to actually hear from travelers. Was there notice? Was there consent? Was there signage? What happened if you try to opt out? Could you actually opt out without consequences? So we certainly discussed where the U.S. could lead when it comes to biometrics rights.
Dr. Joy, it's interesting the comparison between the European Union and what we see in the United States. Did President Biden give you any sort of indication or pledge that the U.S. will kind of be more active in regulating or at least acting on a framework in terms of guardrails for artificial intelligence technology?
Well, something that I was encouraged to see last year from the Biden-Harris administration was the release of a blueprint for an AI Bill of Rights. And I think that's exactly the way the U.S. should approach regulating AI, right, which is a rights-based framework. And so here you would have specific protections against algorithmic discrimination. There would be notice and explanation. There would be privacy when it comes to data and consent, and these systems would have to be shown to be safe and effective. In the case of Robert Williams being falsely arrested, the system wasn't even effective. But even if we had more effective biometric systems, this then can lead to mass state surveillance, which is not the society we want to have here in the United States.
At MIT, tell me about your research. What are you focused on?
So my research looks into bias in various types of AI systems. So probably most known for the gender shades paper, which showed racial bias and gender bias in commercially sold products from IBM, Microsoft. Later on, we also did Amazon as well. Right now with the Algorithmic Justice League, we're focused on real world harms. How are people experiencing AI systems being used for access to government services? So for example, we know that the IRS put on board ID.me as a way of accessing basic tax information. But we launched a campaign and we heard from many people saying that they were having so many different issues, not just from the technical side, but also from a privacy side. And when you have a company that says to use our system, you waive your right to sue, but there's no other way to access that government service, we are moving in the wrong direction. But it's not too late to course correct.
Dr. Joy, the core of your research and your role is looking at the societal risks of AI. But how do you yourself use artificial intelligence tools? Would you say that you are pro AI as a tool to advance mankind?
I am optimistic about using ethical AI systems. And what I try to do is say, are the AI systems that I would like to use built on an ethical pipeline? And if not, are there ways we can shift that? I'm very excited, for example, with what we're seeing with AI and healthcare. There's a startup called Bloomer Tech, where they've identified a major health gap, which is about 1 in 3 women die of cardiovascular disease, but less than a quarter of research participants are women when it comes to actually studying the disease. So we have a very male-centric model of heart disease, and this does mean that women have worse outcomes. So they've developed this innovation of smart fabrics that can give you digital biomarkers. And they are also addressing this data gap because there's such a lack of data when it comes to women's heart health. So those sorts of areas, I'm very excited about the possibilities where AI isn't taking away livelihoods, but improving life outcomes.